students, today our topic is combination of sentences into single simple sentence. Earlier you have learned how to join two sentences into one simple sentence using infinitive and gerund. Today we'll be learning how to join two sentences into simple sentence by using preposition with a noun or a gerund. Let us quickly recapitulate what is preposition and gerund. Preposition: words used to connect people, object, time and location of sentences. Prepositions like on, or, before, after, to, etc. can be used with a noun or a gerund to join two sentences into single simple sentence. Now, gerund. Gerund is ing form of a verb which acts as a noun. For example, playing, working, giving, etc. Now, the situations can be broadly classified into three categories. First, in addition to. When there is one action in addition to another action. Basically, whenever you feel like using and to join two sentences, preposition besides can be used. Now, there is a rule, children. Generally, besides is followed by ing form of verb. For example, besides playing, besides working, etc. Let us take an illustration. She gave us her advice, full stop. She helped us with money. Now you can see both the sentences are having same subject, that is she. So we'll use she only once in the sentence. Now the verb in the first sentence is gave. So gave will become giving. So the answer would be, besides giving us her advice, comma, s small, she helped us with money, full stop. Other than that, there is another case in which main verbs are is, am, are, was or were. In these situations, they are replaced by being. Now let us take an example. He is a painter, full stop. He is a poet. Now again, students, subjects are same, so we'll use he once only. The verb in the first sentence is, so is will change into being. Answer would be, besides being a painter, comma, he is a poet. Now, second situation is contrast. When the sentences are opposite or contrasting in nature. So basically, whenever you feel like using but in order to join two sentences, we can use words like in spite of, despite and withal. Now, the rule regarding, first rule regarding use of despite is that we never use of with despite. Another is same as besides, that is, it is followed by ing form of verb. And with all is always followed by noun or pronoun. Let us take an example. He came late, he was not punished. So he came late, but he was not punished. Instead of but, we can use in spite of or despite. How we can use that? Came will change into coming. Again, subjects are same, so he will be used once only.